Hello everyone, Xenu Zamira. Welcome back to Let's Play Hyrule Warriors Definitive Edition. Last time, well, we met Lana, and, well, we'll be playing one of the Legends maps, if you guys remember which one. Good. But, we're first talking about Skull Kid, because he's actually going to be kind of relevant. Yeah, that sometimes happens, Skull Kids. The main thing you're going to be using is the goddamn laser, because it comes out quick. Again, it doesn't... because it's meant a drop-down puppet from... I almost said Zelda 2. I don't know why. I definitely 100% do not know why, because Zelda 2 is not Twilight Princess. Granted, that's a game I couldn't beat because my game got scratched. So... But yeah, Skull Kid's kind of fun. My only problem is that... well, his best attack is literally a quick laser. Like, literally, this does so much. Like, do you see me trying? Okay, now, hopefully. Yeah, this is what it's meant to do. If you're good at controlling it, I believe you can literally get her around full 360. But that's all. And this is the Master Quest map. I do not like it. I really do not like it. But soon we'll be getting to the maps that I find are interesting. Like I said, I'm switching to Hard, Fire and Woods, as Linkle with the crossbows.
Oi, oi, was a girl who lived in a small village. She led a simple life, tending to her flock of cuckoos. Her name was Linkle. For as long as she could remember, Linkle had believed in her heart that she was the hero reborn. One day, terrible news arrived at her village. Monsters had laid siege to Hyrule Castle. Linkle caught word of the monster's attack and immediately began preparations. She dressed the part in her green tunic. Equipped with her trusty crossbows and the ancient compass her grandmother bestowed on her, Linkle set out from the village. This treasured compass and a crude map were all she had to guide her way to Hyrule Castle. In no time at all, she found herself lost in the Mirkwood forest. An imp in a curious mask appeared out of nowhere and stole Linkle's precious compass. That compass, she knew, was proof of her destiny. She had to go back. And thus began Linkle's first true trial.
And now you know why I decided to play Skull Kid. Majora's Puppet, Skull Kid. So Linkle, I actually really like. Yeah, with an army of cuckoos. Run over. Now let's guide that cuckoo to the feeding area. There we go. How did it do that? Magic. I mean, I originally, in the game, did want that. Yeah, well, don't worry, game. I just need to get the cuckoo. Safe. There's another chick that's going to become a gold cuckoo. Now let's get this one. Goodbye, Poe. Now we've got another cuckoo. Skull Kid. Thank you. Now let's go save the cuckoo before we finish up Skull Kid. Now, let's finish off Skull Kid. And we never get to see that one opened. Believe in her, Hero. You probably will. But here? Nope. Oh. We're going the wrong way.
Linkle left her village, vowing to restore peace to Hyrule. In her hand, she clutched her grandmother's precious compass. But before long, a mischievous imp had stolen the treasured possession. Linkle chased down the imp and tried to retrieve the compass. And then, something strange happened. As if in response to her struggle, the compass began emitting a mysterious light. It seemed to be reacting to her. Linkle recovered it, hung it from her neck, and vowed never to lose it again. The compass's light was quite a mystery to her. She didn't know what secret power it might hold. Whatever the case, it had to be a sign of her status as the legendary hero. If she could harness this power, perhaps she would fully realize her destiny and save Hyrule. Her faith renewed, Linkle continued her quest.
Yep. Good trail clear. and really fun. Too bad River Style is not. But next time, we do The Sorceress of the Valley. And, play as Lana, our new character. See you guys then. Xenozuma, signing out.